Hey guys, how are you doing? In this episode, we are going to see about a problem that iPhone users are experiencing after updating to iOS 17. Even with the latest iOS 17.0.3, this problem exists. And recently, I have done an episode about iOS 17 bugs and problems that if you are using iOS 16, it is recommended to stay in iOS 16 version till the iOS 17.1 or the next version comes up with plenty of bug fixes and overall stability improvements. When it comes to the iOS 17.0.3, if you have already updated to the latest version and experiencing this problem, like whenever you receive the first incoming call, the caller ID section will be blank. Only the country data will be given here on the screen, and you won't be seeing the incoming caller number or the name, even though if the ID is already saved, the number is already saved in your phone book. The same happens for the call waiting also, like for the second incoming call that goes in call waiting also shows this option without any number or contact name at the top caller ID section. So this is clearly iOS 17 bug, and even the latest iOS 17.0.3 haven't addressed this issue. And this is the release note of iOS 17.1 release candidate version 2, which Apple released just yesterday for iPhone 15 models particularly. And this contains, you know, plenty of bug fixes, and the same release candidate 2 version is going to be released for all the compatible iPhone and iPad models next week. As per the leaks and rumors, 24th October is going to be the date where we will see the official release of iOS 17.1. If you've already updated to iOS 17 version, it is must to update to the 17.1 as it brings plenty of bug fixes and stability improvements. I'm using the 17.1 version in my iPhone 15 Plus, and so far it is stable and works perfect with my device. And I have also checked with a couple of my friends who are using the beta. Currently it is in developer beta, iOS 17 release candidate version 2, and so far it is working perfect. Plenty of bug fixes have already done, and I can feel the overall stability improvements. There are a few minor hiccups here and there, but it is much stable and better than the iOS 17 previous updates, the 0.1, 0.2 and 0.3. So as you can see from the release note, they have already addressed this issue of incoming caller ID names are not properly displayed, and it is already mentioned in the release notes of the release candidate version 2. And right now it is only developer beta, and public beta is expected in probably tonight or tomorrow. And along with that, you can see plenty of other bug fixes that are very essential to get a stable overall iPhone, you know, iOS usage experience have already come with this. And iOS 17.1 also brings the AirDrop via internet feature to all the compatible iPhone and iPad models. So you don't have to keep the phone nearby in order to transfer the data via AirDrop. You can simply step away and the data will still be transferred using your mobile data to the device that you wanted to share or that you are receiving from. They also fixed plenty of other bugs, like the ringtones not appearing, you know, even the purchased ringtone or custom ringtone is not appearing on the sounds and haptic section, which we have already covered in one of the episode. I'll leave a link to that in the description and in the first comment. If you haven't watched it already, you can check that out. Another important bug fix is keyboard not being responsive enough, you know, that sort of bug already fixed with the 17.1 release candidate version 2. So once the official release happens, we will see a much better overall stable experience. Particularly this incoming caller ID not being displayed on your iPhone will also be fixed. So if you're experiencing this problem, make sure you have updated the iOS to the latest iOS 17 version, which is at least 17.1 or later version, and then you will be able to see this bug fixed on your iPhone along with plenty of other bugs. I hope this video helped you to understand why the incoming caller ID name is not being displayed or the call waiting name is not being displayed. Thanks for watching. For more useful iPhone, iPad and Mac related tips and tricks, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you and have a wonderful day.